two, one. Sweetwater Clifton is one of the first African Americans to ever set foot in the NBA and ultimately changed the way the game is played. Standing near me is Martin Gigi. He's directing a movie that's going into production, a feature film about that called Sweetwater. I caught up with him to talk about his movie.
Sweetwater Clifton was the first African American to play in the NBA. It was a boring sport, actually, and Sweetwater really changed the game. You know, he wasn't the first African American to play in the NBA. That's what the story is about of this movie that I'm making. But he was a real inspiring people because he changed the game.
Yeah, he changed the game, changed NBA to what it is today. Otherwise, it wouldn't be as exciting.
That's
no
right.
Dunks.
Right on. That's exactly it.
No long range.
Well, you know what he did? He brought imagination and creativity to the game. And we haven't even made the movie yet, and it's already changed my life and other people's lives.
It's exciting. It's different.
Yeah, it is. It is.
We just talked about basketball movies are very popular.
Yes. And I think the reason, by the way, if you want to cut that back into the other spot, the reason that Hollywood makes basketball and boxing movies and even baseball movies, it's because those are the stories that inspire in a positive manner, have a positive impact on people. Because those are the films that make you want to, when you leave the theater, you want to go do something.
Are you an NBA fan?
I am.
What's your team?
I've been an NBA fan my whole life. I grew up watching the Knicks because I grew up in New York City.
They're doing good this year, surprisingly, with Amari.
Yeah, it's okay.
Went to Israel, got a blessing.
It's okay to say you're a New York Knicks fan now. It is. It's safe to say it.
They might get Omri Caspi from the Sacramento Kings, and that would help them.
That's right. Little by little, you know, they'll be. The East is real strong, and that's really cool, man. Yeah, I've been a Knicks fan all along. But you know what I love? I love great basketball teams. I was a fan of the Pat Riley's Heat. I was a fan of teams that play team ball. Do you remember that old Sacramento Kings team? That was a good team. That was fun to
Lawrence
watch.
Lawrence Funderburk.
Yeah.
You had White Chocolate.
Right
Chris
on.
Weber.
That's right. White Chocolate.
Peja Stojakovic.
Vladi. Yeah.
You had Scott Pollard. So many great
Bobby
players.
Bobby Jackson. Good team. Mm-hmm. And they played team ball. Celtics are playing team ball. I love to watch. Oklahoma's playing team ball. Those guys, you know, that's exciting to me. Great teams that play team ball, man, that's exciting to me.
One time I told Bobby Jackson he looks just like Flavor Flav. Do you know who's starring in it?
Wood Harris.
Wood Harris?
Wood Harris. James Caan.
James Caan.
Danny DeVito.
Danny DeVito. He can't ball. Is he the coach?
Yeah.
But Martin, why do you love basketball so much?
It's such a great sport because, you know, it's a team game, but it also allows you to excel individually. Like, and you learn something about it every time. I learn something about basketball every time I play. It's also for me like a real good metaphor for life about looking for that open man. Something about, what do I love basketball? What is there not to love about basketball?
So, there you have it, Martin Gigi. Look out for the movie Sweetwater. You won't want to miss it. It's going to be very inspirational. Besides, if you love basketball, there's one movie you won't want to miss. In Los Angeles, I'm elie Seckbach reporting.